Welcome. In the last modules, we have learned that organ transplantation has a lot of advantages. There is, however, also an other side of the coin. Here, we focus on the risk of malignancies after prolonged immunosuppression in the transplant recipient. After this lecture, you will be able to answer the following questions. What is the incidence of malignancies in transplant recipients? What are the risk factors? And how can we prevent and treat them? Malignancy is a major adverse outcome of transplantation. In this lecture, we will first focus on the incidence of malignancies in transplant recipients. Taken all malignancies together, the risk is 2 times increased compared with the immunocompetent population. The lifelong immunosuppression is responsible for the increased risk. Malignancies can be divided in infection-related and non-infection related. The most common infection-related malignancies include non-Hodgkin lymphoma and liver cancer. In addition, there's a high incidence of some rare tumors, including Kaposi's sarcoma. The most common non-infection malignancies are lung and kidney cancer. First, we look at the infection-related malignancy in this picture of the human body. Demonstrated is the standardized incidence ratio, which is calculated as the quotient of the observed and the expected number of cases of infection-related malignancies in the transplant recipients. As you can see, the standardized incidence ratio of non-Hodgkin lymphomas is 7.5 times increased and liver carcinoma is 11.5 times increased. In addition, some relative rare malignancies have a high frequency, for example, Kaposi's sarcoma is 61 times increased. So you see that the risk of infection-related malignancies are markedly increased. Also, non-infection-related malignancies show an increased incidence in transplant recipients. In this picture, you can see the risk of non-infection-related malignancies. The risk of lung cancer is 2 times increased, whereas the risk for kidney cancer is 4.7 times increased. Finally, the risk for skin malignancies is up to 100 times increased. Skin malignancies can be divided into malignant melanoma and non-melanoma skin cancer, also called keratinocyte carcinoma. The risk of malignant melanoma is 2 to 5 times increased. Keratinocyte carcinoma can be divided into 2 subtypes, basal cell carcinoma and squamous cell carcinoma. The risk of basal cell carcinoma is 10 times increased and the risk of squamous cell carcinoma is 50 to 100 times increased. There is still some debate whether these malignancies are infection-related or non-infection-related. In the rest of this lecture, we will focus on cutaneous squamous cell carcinomas, since these form the largest part of the malignancies developed after transplantation. To illustrate the possible clinical course of a squamous cell carcinoma post-transplant, we will show a clinical case. This patient was transplanted more than 40 years ago. 5 years after the transplantation, he started to develop warts, as you can see here. 10 years after the transplantation, he developed his first squamous cell carcinoma, as shown here. Since then, he developed more than 50 additional squamous cell carcinomas, mainly on sun-exposed skin. Here, we see the cumulative incidence of squamous cell carcinoma in the Netherlands and Australia. The x-axis shows the years after transplantation, and the y-axis, the cumulative incidence of skin cancer. The red bars indicate the Dutch, and the blue bars, the Australian patients. We can see that the cumulative incidence in the Netherlands is 10% 10 years after the transplantation, and 40% 20 years after the transplantation. In Australia, this incidence is even much higher, as you can see. We will now look at the risk factors for squamous cell carcinomas. As already mentioned, the most important risk factor is the lifelong immunosuppression in our patients. But there are more risk factors. Looking at the distribution, most of the tumors are localized on sun-exposed skin. Exposure to the sun is therefore an important risk factor. In earlier days, cutaneous squamous cell carcinomas were considered as non-infection malignancies. More and more data are collected, however, showing that the virus may play a role in their development. Therefore, the third risk factor is foreign viruses. The virus that may be involved is the human papilloma virus. These are DNA viruses that form particles, as is shown here. What could be the role of human papilloma viruses in skin carcinogenesis? We think that these viruses may interact with the mechanisms which prevent and repair sun-induced damage to the skin. Let's have a look how this happens. When we are outside in the sun, we will develop genotoxic damage in the skin, as is shown in red. Normally, this damage is repaired by DNA repair mechanisms, or if the cells are too heavily damaged, they will undergo programmed cell death, also called apoptosis. If there are no problems, the end result will be normal skin. In the presence of human papillomaviruses, however, these mechanisms may be hampered. The DNA damage will not be repaired, and UV-induced apoptosis will not take place. This will result in survival of infected and damaged cells, and on the long run, this process can result in the development of squamous cell carcinomas. Besides the three mentioned risk factors, namely immunosuppression, sun exposure, and human papillomavirus infection, there are other risk factors, including smoking and genetic factors. Take a minute to look at the increased risk ratios. Now you have seen the risk factors and mechanisms involved, could you think of methods to prevent or treat post-transplant malignancies? Lowering or changing the immunosuppressors could be considered. However, the risk of developing reactions should be taken into account. Since sun exposure plays a major role in the development of cutaneous squamous cell carcinoma, sun protection is very important. Other ways to decrease the risk of skin cancers are oral and local retinoids, photodynamic therapy, and topical treatment of the field chains. Skin cancers themselves can be treated with surgical excision and sometimes radiotherapy. In summary, we have seen some important drawbacks and challenges after organ transplantation. Renal transplant recipients have an increased risk of malignancies because of lifelong immunosuppression, increased risk of infection, especially viruses, and for skin malignancies, sun exposure also plays a major role. For prevention, sun protection is very important. In the optional readings, you can find additional information about skin malignancies in the transplant recipient. Malignancy is not the only challenge. In the next lectures, we will focus on metabolic and cardiovascular challenges.